you're watching Wolverine TV.
Hey, Rome Science! Welcome back to another episode of Wolverine TV. I'm Julia.
And I'm Grace. Let's kick off this week's episode with Events with Emmett.
Hey, Rome Science! Welcome back to Events with Emmett, where I'll be catching up on events happening in the school. The second working period will be ending next Tuesday. The fall play, The Laramie Project, 10 years later, will be taking place next week in the auditorium. It will be at 4 p.m. on Wednesday and Thursday, and 6 p.m. on Friday. That's all for this week, Rome Science. Back to you guys.
Cool. Thank you, Emmett.
Now let's see how you guys react to this segment of Teachers React.
And what did you get?
2 times 2 is 63.
You're what? On the right track. You're right and wrong. But I can tell you're getting warmer. Go back to your desk. Look up the notes one more time. One more time.
I see myself doing this.
I do too. Well, not the strange noises, I hope.
It's morning.
So I feel like...
But I don't eat. I don't do...
You wouldn't eat. Yeah, yeah.
This is a TikTok.
Yeah.
Okay.
Does that change everything for you?
I don't know what
it's... Total valence electrons. Do you guys see where I'm coming from here? Okay, guys, listen. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask me. There are no stupid questions in this class. I mean, yes, Nick? You gotta be kidding me. Okay, have you been paying attention at all this class? Seriously, guys, I teach this stuff over and over again, and you have the audacity to...
Wait, did it say bathroom?
No, it was, what the question was actually a stupid question.
Oh.
The premise is that when the teacher says that there's no stupid questions, that they're lying to you. Because this teacher feels disrespected, but it's a trap. It's a trap for the students. They're saying, you know.
There isn't,
but there is.
Sure.
chemistry is difficult.
That was terrific, teachers.
Now let's go to Clubbing with Kyla.
Hey, Wrong Science, I'm Kyla, and welcome back to another episode of Clubbing with Kyla, where I help you figure out what interests you here at Wrong Science. With me today is the president of the Nashat Club. So, first question, what do you guys do at Nashat?
So basically at Nashat, it's just a safe space for South Asian students of Wrong Science and people who are interested in South Asian culture to come and connect with each other. We do this by playing games, watching Bollywood movies. We have a lot of fun. We plan for a lot of our events, like the Nashat Show, Homecoming, the Nashat and MSA Eid Party, and we just have a good time.
So, next question, what is your favorite Nashat Club event?
So, my favorite event at Nashat has to be the Nashat Show. We haven't had one in 2 years, but I think this year's Nashat Show is going to be super awesome. All of the members of the club are working really hard to choreograph and learn their songs and dances to show Wrong Science what Nashat has to bring.
So, last question, how long has the Nashat Club been around? Is it a new club or has it been around for a long time?
No, it's a pretty old club. I think we came around in the 90s. And a lot of our traditions and like a lot of the things that we do are passed on from like past club members. Our like banners, everything is just passed on from past club members. And I think there's like a lot of history to this club, and I think that's what makes us so strong. And I look forward to seeing everyone there.
All right, that's amazing. Make sure to check out the Nashat Club on Thursdays at 3:45 in room 319.
Hope to see you there.
That's all for me. Now back to you guys.
I love this club.
You know what else I love? To roll some promotions.
Get it. Got an email from the Esser cabinet. Tongue about it dry, toys cans and clothes. Don't name my items, y'all already know. To help people, both young and old. And I'd like to give a shout out to those with a game plan. And shout out to the students with a ready plans. 10 cans, 20 cans. We can either donate now or we can make plans. Boxes loaded, bins loaded, okay, let's rock and roll this. November 17th to December 15th, reach our goal. Donations overflowing, the drive's just begun. Let's keep on going. Prizes to the winners, you already know it. If you want some merch, you gotta show it. The clothes with tags, the toys, brand new. donate, pursue, increase, breakthrough. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I donate my items, the numbers will soar. I donate what's mine, then donate some more. The numbers will soar, the numbers will soar. I came, I saw, I came, I saw. I donate my items, the numbers will soar. I donate what's mine, then donate some more. The numbers will soar, the numbers will soar.
Yeah. I donate the toys, the cans, the clothes. I flow great, you know, new clothes, not old. The shirts, the soup, the fruit and the beans. The gloves, the boots, come through with the greens. So stop in line, observe the signs. Go shop, go drive, it's time to shine. To shine, to shine, to shine, to shine. For city, harvest, you know, it's time. The Bowery mission and toys for tots. We donate, we're driven, we do our part. So be sure to bring everything that you've got. Your toys, your cans, your clothes.
If you have any promos you want us to air, email them to us at wolverinetv@bxscience.edu. We can't wait to see them.
And make sure to follow us on Instagram at @BXIWolverineTV for more reactionary content.
That's a wrap on this week's episode, people.
Catch you next time. And as always,
thanks for listening.